Ladies and gentlemen, how's it going? It's your boy Frank with another video. So today we are going to do something special. So I'm going to explore a abandoned ceramic compound. So it has been abandoned for years. So we are on holiday, so I was trying to seek for something to do. So I find out that I can actually explore that warehouse. So we are going to go to that compound, and I believe you will be amazed on how big it is and how sad it is to have it on the state that it is. So I hope you enjoyed it. Stay tuned. Let's pick up the car, put some fuel, and bounce. Ooh, so the baby is now with some fuel so we can hit the road. Let's go. Something funny about the city where I am now in Quelimane is that a lot of people use bicycles here for almost everything. I mean, you can see bicycles carrying on almost everything, from people to grocery store stuff. So it's quite impressive on how they use bicycles around here. So let's keep driving until we reach the factory.
Love you has taught me never let go on a good thing.
So basically this is how it looks from the car, and I will show you from the street. You can see that tower from the middle of the street.
Whoa, do what you want to do with me.
Oh my god, because I love you. So they officially ceased the production in 2005. So since then, the whole factory has been abandoned. That's like really, really sad, because it was a very huge power plant here in Zambezia regarding to bricks and ceramics. They used to produce ceramics for housing, and ceramics also for furniture, right? So they did receive special line for electricity. As you can see, it's not working anymore. But yeah, this is a huge investment, which now you can try to look at this. That's like huge, 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 huge. I think they used to load things from here, as you can see this rhyme.
You don't know, it makes me feel so good.
even have to have rails inside, so in order to make sure that they could move the bricks and stuff. As you can see right here, those kind of rails. I don't know what this was used for, but it looks like a track or something. And as you can see, now this is flooded with water, and people use this water for laundry, for housekeeping. And you can see how this was very well built, because since they ceased operations, it has been abandoned for years. And you can kind of see it. Whoa. I am speechless with what I'm seeing here. Oh my God. Like, this is unreal. I've been passing from the ceramic for a while, and getting an opportunity to come here inside and see how it is. Well, it's scary and it's amazing. You can kind of see the type of machines that they used to have here. Whoa. And you can see some kind of rails. I think they used to move thing around. Oh, this is deep. Someone used to work down there. In the bad news, Ritz is the unfeeling story. Whoa, this is deep. We can kind of see the brand of machinery that they were using here. Man, some huge stuff was going on here. Whoa. I think those used to be the circuit breakers for turning on and off the machines. So maybe this was the command. And you can see how huge the motors they have been using. Man, I think there was a lot of noise inside here. Whoa. This is speechless and amazing. Oh my God. I think they used to put water there inside. Wow, look at the tracks. Yo guys, we have some really old stuff here. That brand Morando actually was founded in 1874, And that company opened up in Mozambique, the ceramic, in 1956. Man.
So I think all this machinery came from Italy. Oh.
I'll try to search for you guys the date of that all of this stuff was manufactured. In order to show
how old those were.
Those are. So I think this is the place that they used to bake everything there. Wow. Impressive. And you can see there, this is where they used to bake the bricks. Inside there. It's kinda scary. And you can see all the lines down there. And I believe you can see where they used to bake.
I don't know. But it seems to be something related to steam. Maybe they used to have machines that were moved with steam.
So I'm going upstairs. Just to give you an overview on how big this was. You can kind of see it. So those are the trails that they used to have, I think, to move things down here. This is huge. We go down. There was a lot of things that I hear the noise. There's a lot of things that were going on here. I think those machines were moved by steam. So I don't know for what they use this, but it's huge. Oh my god, there is a lot of underground things going on in here. So I think they used to have water and look, these kind of things that they used to change rails in order to move, I mean, trails under the production site. This is impressive. So I didn't show this machine from the back. So I think they used to have belts up there. And this maybe was the exhaust system. And I think that a lot of noise was going on here. houses down here, as you can see. So I think this all was to move this big machine around here. Impressive. But look at this. They use this thing to cut something. Official Morando. My God. You can actually see how big this was. My God, and all this was run by like electricity. Whoa. Man, this is huge. So I think they used to change the speeds there. You can see Velocita 1 and Velocita 2. Wow. Made it back to the car and whoa. I'm still impressed. Let me turn on the AC. Ooh, it's very hot. Oh my God, this was huge, huge, huge. So, as I told you, I will show you from the street. And you can see it from down here. And you can see the tower. It was huge. And I mean, all the town was underbuilt from that factory. Yeah. So as you can see, I made it back home and I'm packed with my coconuts. So I hope you did enjoy the video as much I did when I was there searching for things. So that's it. The video ends up here. I hope you enjoyed it and see you soon. Cheers.